Greetings. I did not quite finish the topic of the previous video. I described the message of the prophets about sacrificing blood and the sacrifice of Messiah. But I did not really address the position the original poster claimed for Allah's forgiveness. The fact is, there is one truth and an infinity of errors, fables, and other falsehoods. In part one, I presented the true message of the prophets. Now I would like to examine and dissect the Islamic position claimed in the original post. Here is the original post making a claim about the Allah of Muhammad's religion. Muslims, Allah is merciful and forgives a sinner through his sincere repentance. That sounds nice and simple and easy, but simply does not agree with the religion the prophets of God revealed. Please do not make a mistake. Repentance is a critical part of accepting God's free gift of salvation. Acts 3:12, and when Peter saw it, he answered unto the people, "You men of Israel, why marvel you at this? Or why look you so earnestly on us, as though by our power or holiness we had made this man to walk?" Okay, I love it when the Spirit of God does this to me. This video has just taken a turn for the better, my Muslim brother. Acts 3:1. Now Peter and John were going up to the temple at the ninth hour, the hour of prayer. This is after Jesus was resurrected. This was after the day of Pentecost. The Comforter, the Holy Spirit, has been poured out. Now, I know Islam tries to claim Muhammad is the Comforter. If you are Muslim, please pay attention to what happens next to the followers of Jesus and by the followers of Jesus. Verse 2, and a man who had been lame from his mother's womb was being carried along, whom they used to set down every day at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, in order to beg alms of those who were entering the temple. So this man has been lame since birth. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he began asking to receive alms. But Peter, along with John, fixed his gaze on him and said, "Look at us." You know how when we don't want to deal with a beggar, we avoid eye contact? I think the unfortunate know that too, don't you? Well, Peter did more than eye contact. Peter spoke to the man. Peter actually tried to get his attention. "Look at us." And he, the beggar, began to give them his attention, expecting to receive something from them. But Peter said, "I do not possess silver and gold." I'm sure the beggar had a jolt hearing that part. "Great. But what I do have, I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, walk." Now remember, dear Muslim brother or sister, Islam claims Jesus did not die on the cross. Surah 4, 157. Islam claims Jesus was nothing more than a prophet born of a virgin. The Quran claims the miracles are with Allah. The Quran claims Jesus only healed by Allah's permission. The Quran claims Allah tricked Peter and John and all the other Muslim disciples of Jesus. How exactly then? How does the Quran or Muhammad or Allah explain the following events? And seizing him up by the right hand, he raised him up, and immediately his feet and his ankles were strengthened. Remember, this beggar has never taken a step in his entire life. With a leap, he stood upright and began to walk. And he entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. How exactly then does the Quran or Muhammad or Allah explain that happening? Surely you believe the miracles are with Allah, right? And this man was healed, totally and miraculously. This man not only was strengthened, God instantly gave this man a developed sense of balance to walk and leap. He did not simply stand with help from other people to keep from falling over. With a leap, he stood upright and began to walk. And he entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. If you think Muhammad's Allah, your Allah, is the source of miracles, then Peter healed this man by Allah's permission, right? Surely you believe the miracles are with Allah, right? But Peter did not say, "I heal you by Allah's permission." Peter said, "In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, walk." So I ask again, dear Muslim, how exactly does the Quran or Muhammad or Allah explain this miracle that glorifies Jesus? This is one of those historical events that really proves to Christians Jesus is who he said he was. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. Remember, this man was lame from birth. This man was daily at the temple to beg for alms. And they were taking note of him as being the one who used to sit at the beautiful gate of the temple to beg alms. The Jews who came to the temple knew this man. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. Amazing indeed. Peter has healed a man born lame. But we do not worship Peter, nor claim this was some magic. We know Jesus Christ healed this man, as Jesus said. But Peter said, "I do not possess silver and gold, but what I do have, I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, walk." In John 14:13, Jesus said, "And whatever you might ask in my name, this will I do, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son." The name of Jesus Christ. John 14:14, "If you ask me anything in my name, I will do it." The name of Jesus Christ. We know Jesus Christ healed this man, as Jesus said. But when Peter saw this, he replied to the people, "Men of Israel, why are you amazed at this, or why do you gaze at us? As if by our own power or piety we had made him walk." Well, this sounds like Peter is about to give Allah the glory. The God of Abraham and of Isaac and of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his son Jesus, whom you delivered up and denied him in the presence of Pilate when Pilate was determined to let him go. But you denied the Holy One and the Just, and desired a murderer, Barabbas, to be granted unto you. And you killed the Author of life. Amazing. This is Peter, good Muslim and all, calling Jesus the Author of life. I know, you really want to think Surah 4:157 is true. Allah deceived Peter, and Peter does not know any better. Then why did the lame beggar get healed? Was Allah simply continuing his lie to Peter and the disciples? The miracles are with Allah, right? O Muhammad, if Allah sent you, work a miracle. I cannot. The miracles are with Allah. I am nothing but a warner. O Muhammad, the Apostle Peter worked miracles. Truly, the God of Abraham sent Peter. And as you say, Muhammad, you are nothing. And you killed the Author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. Who are we to believe, my Muslim brother? The Apostle Peter, who God proved? Or one man alone who got the facts all wrong and did nothing? And his name, by faith in his name, has made this man strong whom you see and know. And the faith that is through Jesus has given the man this perfect health in the presence of you all. Oh, brother, the miracles are with God, and Jesus is God. That is how Jesus can promise to answer prayers. I said this video had just taken a turn for the better, my Muslim brother. Peter healed a man born lame in the authority of the name of Jesus, Yeshua. And Islam is powerless to even consider the meaning. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.